Sepsis is when the body's response to infection is abnormal and then damages the body's own tissues and organs. It can be a very serious disease, so approximately 20 to 50% of people who are admitted with suspected sepsis will end up dying within that first admission.
The problem is that it's enigmatic, can present in a number of different ways, and therefore can be very challenging for busy clinicians to detect.
It can affect patients quickly, so a patient can deteriorate literally in front of your eyes. And so rapid diagnosis and giving the right treatments quickly definitely improves patient outcomes, and it does save lives.
So we recognised within Guy's and St Thomas's that we didn't have very robust numbers on the numbers of patients that we were seeing who had sepsis. That was a gap in our understanding of the condition.
So we needed a way of measuring what we were doing and then understanding what we were doing badly in order to improve.
We approached that question by trying to understand how we could apply some of our electronic data to exactly that problem.
We were asked to provide a clinical decision-making tool that would aid clinicians in the diagnosis of sepsis, and then provide another tool that would allow clinicians to actually record the six key tasks that need to be completed in the first hour of diagnosis. Collaboration and co-creation were key to this project. We worked very closely with the sepsis team, who provided all of the clinical information and requirements for the tools, but together with our colleagues within DT&I as well, to really get the best product for our clinicians that would involve using conditional logic and not add towards stress.
It was really refreshing to develop that kind of project with such a team, because we got a whole range of different inputs and different expertises and different insights.
We benefited from working with technologists, but also with transformation in terms of their ability to think about the quality improvement and the transformation that would need to support the digital tool.
The screening tool helps by directing clinicians to think about sepsis as a cause for deterioration, what the source might be, and therefore what the management is.
So day to day, our clinicians enter a lot of data into a lot of different IT systems. If we can develop ways where they don't have to enter that data yet again and run algorithms for them, that helps them because it minimises their time with the computer and hopefully maximises it with the patient.
So far, I'm excited. I think over the July-August period, we've captured a good amount of patients. I think it is showing us that we are making the diagnosis. I think it is helping us not underdiagnose or overdiagnose. And we get the Sepsis 6 bundle, which is a package of care, a pathway of care for a patient, that we can utilise that package of care as quickly as possible.
It's been received very well by our nursing colleagues on the ward. It's now embedded in their daily practice, so a lot of the nurses are just doing this as part of their regular thing.
The tool is saving lives. It's stopping patients from deteriorating. It's triggering treatment quickly. It's stopping our patients from becoming so unwell that we've missed our opportunity to get treatment into them.
So data is always going to be key to quality improvement. The strength of this approach is it allows us to capture data on sepsis. It allows us to refine our definitions of sepsis, to understand the cohort and our management, to use standardised definitions and outcomes in order to benchmark ourselves against other organisations.
What we have also done, though, is that we went back to those clinicians who have completed the tool to ask them for their feedback, to find out what's working, what perhaps needs changing.
We know that collaboration between clinical teams and technical teams and operational teams is fundamental to success. These teams enjoy working together and design better pathways.
It's not very often that as an IT person you can be involved with the actual saving of patients' life. That's a great thing.
Sepsis is a killer. So getting that right, it's why we're here. And getting it right for staff, this is something that worries staff, it worries clinicians, being able to treat sepsis promptly and correctly. So not only did it have a profound impact on both patients and staff in terms of doing things well, but it also means that as a fundamental barometer of how we deliver healthcare, outcomes for really important conditions such as this are absolutely crucial.